Let's look at naming nitriles, another carboxylic acid derivative. So, as a priority group, if the nitrile is our highest priority group in the compound on this list, it will be named with the suffix nitrile at the end of the parent chain name. If, however, we are a subordinate group, and so there's something higher on this list than the nitrile also present, we'll name it as, say, an ester with a cyano group on that same compound. So the nitrile would then subjugate to a cyano group. We're going to circle the parent chain, being careful to write the names of any group that intersects those chains or that circle chain. Number the chain with the appropriate IUPAC priority for numbering, and we'll assemble the name, checking for stereochemistry. So this is a way to be careful about naming compounds so we don't make careless errors. Let's look at the first example. So our highest priority group on our list between a ketone and a nitrile is the nitrile. And so we have to have that group in our parent chain. We then find the longest carbon-to-carbon chain that also contains that highest priority group. Anything intersecting our circle gets a name. And so we've got a methyl group here, and we've got an oxo group, as we'll see. From ketone naming, an oxo group will be applied to both ketones and aldehydes that are in the parent chain but are not the highest priority group. So oxo. Putting this name together, we need a number first. So we need a lowest priority or highest priority on the priority group. And notice the carbon of the nitrile is numbered, okay? So it counts as part of the parent chain. That's one thing that we see as a mistake quite often, is we don't get that carbon from the nitrile into the parent chain. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Stereochemistry wise, carbon to nitrogen, it gets a 1, 2, and a 3 for carbon to carbon here, and then group 4 is going back away from us. Hydrogen, that's a counterclockwise 1 to 2 to 3, so that's an S stereocenter as well. Putting this name together, we would call this compound an S in alphabetical order with the groups 2-methyl-5-oxo-hexane-nitrile. Okay, so we put the E in, so we don't have hex and nitrile, two consonants together. We put in hexane nitrile to split that up with the E. Okay, so not a pentane nitrile, but a hexane nitrile, counting that carbon of the nitrile. So what if there's more than one present? We remember to number the nitrile 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. And so we would call this a hexane dinitrile. Okay, and we don't need numbers because as a nitrile, we can't number through carbon. And so we end up with hexane dinitrile being the bookends of this parent chain. If the nitrile is not the highest priority group, we would subjugate it and call it a cyano group. So if we look, the cyano group counts for the CN, so the highest priority group here is actually our ester. So our ester here is going to have a higher priority than the nitrile on our original list. So we're going to name this as an ester. That would be a cyano group. And then look at this. We've got a chloro, a 1,2. See here, a chloroethyl, a 1-chloroethyl. Group with chirality, so that's a 1-chlorine higher atomic number than oxygen, 1, 2, 3, that's an R, 1-chloroethyl group that we'll put at the beginning of the name. Okay, so naming esters, we need to name that group attached to oxygen first, so that's an R, 1 chloro ethyl, skip a space there, we need a second word, 3-cyano, how many carbons? 3, propanoate. So R1 chloroethyl 3-cyano propanoate is our final name.